181 Regent Street was actually the original premises for the Black Theatre that was formed back in the early 70s. There was a lot of protests at the time, and so they were doing street theatre to get the message across about the protest. Back in Melbourne, at exactly the same time, Jack Charles, who many might know now, has come out with a new solo play. He formed a company called Neanderthana, and through that they had come back up to Sydney, and along with Paul Coe, the late Bob Mazar, quite a number of people got together and formed this company. Over the years it went on to produce shows such as Basically Black, with Gary Foley, of course, on ABC television, Justine Saunders, Brian Siren, led by extraordinary elders. If you look at the political period, we just had the referendum, the 1967 referendum, where Australia voted yes, that Aboriginal people should be counted on the national census. There was this whole expectation amongst the community that things were going to change. No longer would you need a dog tag. The colour bars in regional towns would lift their 6 p.m. curfews. So there were big things happening around the country. Aboriginal children being allowed into high school. And of course, the very generation of people appreciating this new freedom saw a platform. And that platform could be the theatre where they could actually discuss the very issues that were occurring in the community. So it gave them a whole new voice, and in that voice, this incredible renaissance began. The legacy was incredible, especially for someone like myself coming into the arts in the 80s. It showed us that there's more opportunities for us. It showed us that we could possibly do anything. When Justine Saunders appeared on Pig and the Poke, we were allowed to stay up because an Aboriginal woman was on the television. Now that might not seem like anything to most people, but that was like so historical that we were allowed to stay up because we could actually see an Aboriginal who was on the television playing a secretary, because the only images we ever saw of an Aboriginal on TV, of course, was in the marches or being arrested. And it's interesting going through that history of black theatre and reminiscing and then looking towards where we are with theatre. And I guess we really still learn a lot from those old knowledge keepers, because they were very political, they were very brave, they were speaking out about things that perhaps were not politically correct, and smoothed the way for us so that we did have representation within the dominant culture across television, stages, film. People were seeing films where they were laughing, Basically Black, barbecue area. They could see the very dry sense of humour we have as a group of people. They could also see the stories like the stolen children that perhaps at that period of time they didn't quite believe that that had been the history of this nation. Our culture is really the embodiment of us. It's our spirituality. It's everything that connects us to our rituals and our traditions, and when we talk of walking on country. I think those people that are in this exhibition, 181, are the very knowledge keepers that have maintained and revitalized a new era of the oldest living culture in the world. And I think that's something that's incredibly profound.